This video is going to be all about the tools here that you see in Photoshop. So on the left side of your screen, you should see the tools bar. And over here, if yours looks like this, you'll just press these double chevrons so you could see all the tools. And you could always grab the toolbar and you could have a float by itself. But I just like it here on the side. And for your window, you could actually arrange your workspace to look a little bit different. So if you want things to be floating in windows, if you like that more, or if you don't see as many windows as I see, or if you don't see the toolbar, this is where you could come and change some of the things. So tools over here, if it's turned off, you don't see it. I'm gonna come down window and tools needs to be turned on in order to see that. So again, I have a 27-inch iMac here. So it's a big real estate. That's why a lot of mine are checked on and I could see a lot of different things here. So if you're working on a smaller screen, you might not be able to see the same window that I am. But if you come to windows, you could turn some of these on and off. The ones with the check mark on them are on. The ones that don't have a check mark are off. You could turn those on by just clicking them. So here, the history panel, if I don't want to see that, I'll just go ahead and click that and it should go away. So now I see the properties panel. Again, back to the tools here. The very first tool, I showed you this in the last video, is the move tool. And in order to show you the move tool, let me go to a different Photoshop file that has multiple layers to it. Over here, these are layers. These are how you assemble your Photoshop document. So in this case, it's just one image, one layer. That's background. This is your layer. Over here, multiple layers. So I have the logo layer. You see that? I just turn it on and off by clicking this eyeball. I have this group layer. That's my logo down here, and so on. So in this case, I could really show you the move tool, which comes in really handy. So if I press V, not M actually, V is for move tool. Or if you come here, you could just click your mouse over. It shows you the keyboard shortcut. Again, I've been using Photoshop for a long time, so I'm familiar with the keyboard shortcuts. But in the beginning, you could just come and click these. You don't have to worry about the keyboard shortcuts. In this case, I have the V, the move tool, and I wanted to move this. So I come over here and I select the layer I want to move. In this case, I know that's the logo. And if I just go grab it, I could just move it and place it where I want to. So if I want it in this corner, I just let it go. Again, if I wanted to move the text right here, I can't just grab and then start dragging. This layer is still selected. One of the most useful keyboard shortcuts is Command Z or Control Z on a PC, so I'm gonna press that right now. That just reverts back what I just did. It's under Edit and Undo, basically. So Command Z undoes the last move, so I didn't wanna move that. So if I wanted to move this text, I'll come over here, press V, and then now I could move the text. Same thing with the background. If I wanted to move it, I'll come over here, the screenshot in the background, I could then move it just like that. If I left it here, I could press Command Z, it'll put it back. So that's the move tool. It's a very, very handy tool. I use it probably more than any other tool. The hand tool and the zoom tool, I showed you those. Those allow you to move things around in your document. So the hand tool lets you move things around. If for some reason it's not working, just make sure you switch over to the zoom tool and zoom in and then select the hand tool and move it around. And if you see this little tiny arrow right here, if you click it, that means it's nested with another tool. So if you click that, you could see another tool. So in this case, it's a rotate. So I could actually rotate my image. And that's a handy tool too. But let me just go ahead and go to H. And they have different keyboard shortcuts in this case. The move tool actually has the same keyboard shortcuts for both of the moves. And let me show you a really handy thing up here. If you right click or control click, you could reset a tool. So if for some reason you select one of these tools and you don't like the way it's working, just come up here and reset it and it'll take it back to default. Sometimes if you customize a tool, for example, this rectangle tool, I had really customized it and I couldn't really create the rectangle that I wanted to make. So all I had to do is come up here, control and reset the tool and it set it back to the beginning. Just like that, right now it set it back to the beginning. While we're on this tool, let me show you how this works. I selected the rectangle tool. Again, you see a lot of different options under the rectangle tool. So if you click and drag, you could choose a different one like Eclipse tool. But let me just show you the rectangle tool. All I have to do, these are the settings for that rectangle tool. So when every time you select a different tool, you'll get different settings up here. So even the move tool has its own option. Every time you change your tools, these are the presets for that tool and you could change those things up here. But rectangle, and I'm gonna click and drag, and I'm just dragging, just freeform dragging, and I'm letting go, and there's a rectangle. You made it in black because that was my fill color. Again, I selected that. That was the default fill color. So if I change this to red, for example, and that changed my rectangle to red. Now, if I wanted to create a new rectangle, I just clicked somewhere else here and I'll just switch this to purple, for example. And now I could just drag and create a purple one. And as long as it's selected just like this, if I change the fill color, it will change it like that. If I click away here and I'm not on this layer, these are the layers it created. See, this is the two different layers. So it didn't interrupt the background layer. But now if I let go and if I click here, I could come over here and create a new rectangle. So now I have three different rectangles that is created for me. I could turn each one on and off. And if I don't like one of these, I could select them. And down here is a trash can. I could just press that and say delete that layer. So that's the rectangle tool. The text tool is a very handy tool. So let me just create create a text here. So the text tool, again, has multiple options just like that when you click it. And when you select it, it gives you the options here. So the font, text size, if you want to center the text or if you want to justify left and right, the color. So let me just go ahead and click here and I could start typing. So just like that, I started typing. And now if I wanted to change the font, I could just drag and select all this and I could change the font to be a different font just like that. And it's previewing the different fonts if you look here as I go through it. So if I just want Arial Black, now I got Arial Black and I'm just moving it over here. And everything has to be checked off when it's done. So in this case, I'm done typing. I'm gonna press the check mark. Now it's set. You could always edit this. Again, it's created its own layer one more time. So you could always turn this off and delete this layer, or you come over here and double click and you could change the font size. For example, I could even always type something in like 200 and press the check mark. And then again, the move tool. Now I could show you the move tool in this document. I'll select it, make sure this layer is selected I just created, and I could just move this around. So if I wanted to go ahead and place this in the center, I could just go ahead and do that just like that. I'll just show you a couple of different tools, and the rest of the tools I'm gonna show you when we're editing a image. So in this case, if I wanted to erase something, there is an eraser tool. And the shortcut for that is E, and there's a couple of different options for that as well. But let me just show you the default eraser. If I pick the eraser tool, and let me just click this triangle and I want to erase this triangle. Right now it's not letting me do that because it needs to be, let me just click there. It says this shape must be rasterized before processing. That's fine. I'm just going to press OK. And now I could use the eraser tool to erase it. So just like this, I could erase it the way I want to. Anyway, if you want to get rid of something, you don't obviously have to erase it like this. You could just go ahead and delete that file or use some other tools to alter it, but I just wanted to show you the eraser tool. And again, it's on this layer, so it's not letting me erase this layer. If I wanted to erase this layer, I'll have to click that layer, rasterize it, and then now I could erase that. And if you erase too far, again, always Command Z coming up here, basically either stepping back or Command Z to undo your last step. Stepping backwards allow you to move many steps backwards. Command Z just undoes the last move you did. So I'm just pressing Command Z multiple times. It's just undoing and redoing. If you wanted to go many steps back, you'll just come to edit, step backwards, and that'll take you to some previous steps. So let me just click this a few times. See, now it's taking me back to before I start erasing this layer as well. So some of these other tools, this is the crop tool, for example, that lets you crop an image. There's some brush tools. There's a lot of tools here like the blur tool and the burn tool that really work well with images. And I'll show you some of those a little bit later. Some of these other things like the quick selection tool. This is a really helpful thing when you want to cut something out of an image or create multiple layers from an image. I'll show you that in a different video. So this was a quick overview of the tools. I hope you found this helpful. Please give it a like down below and stay tuned for the next video. Thanks for watching.